Well, good evening and welcome to everybody. I'm Richard Zavala with the City of Fort Worth Public Events Department, and thank you for being here for this historic and special occasion in Fort Worth. Tonight we honor the past and celebrate the present by passing forward this historic landmark to future Fort Worth generations, obligating them to the responsibility of proper stewardship. Tonight we also recognize that over 83 years ago, this community came together and cobbled some funding together, local private funds, local bond funds, leveraged it with state centennial funds and even federal funds, WPA funds, and as a result of that, set the beginning of the Will Rogers Memorial Center. Now, I would be remiss if I did not mention that those local bond funds were park bond funds. So that's an advertisement just for the park department. Tonight, we also celebrate the fact that in 1936, the Pioneer Tower became the centerpiece of the Will Rogers Memorial Complex in this auditorium, in this coliseum. And it was the catalyst, it was the golden spike that set this west side of Fort Worth afire. The results of that are this great cultural district which we had today. So it was in the beginning, it was the genesis, it was the catalyst to everything that happens out here. And the last and most important thing I will share with you is tonight we reaffirm the fact that for generations, this tower has been a reminder of the frontier spirit of this community and what it was built upon. And beginning tonight, once it is lit, it will once again serve as a beacon of hope, of promise, of prosperity, of can-do attitude, that together we can do anything. And that's what we do where the West begins, the place that you and I choose to call home, Fort Worth. So with that, I'll take an applause. I'm going to ask you to warm up your diaphragms because I know she's going to ask you to yell that word so they can hear it as far away as they can from this place. And just so you know, that ball of energy is coming up. If the fuses blow tonight, we've got the mayor hooked up, and that's our backup energy plan. So with that, please join me in welcoming the Honorable Mayor of the City of Fort Worth, Betsy Price.
Pretty good. Y'all are learning this. What a great day to be in Fort Worth, and what fun to see the iconic Pioneer Tower come back to Fort Worth. How many of you grew up in this community? I have to tell you, I'm old enough that I can remember because I grew up just about a 3/4 of a mile west of here. I can remember when this tower was lit, and particularly on summer nights, you could see it. Now, I can't tell you when it went out. I don't remember those details, but it's an exciting time, and it is such a piece of Fort Worth history. If you grew up here, if you're new here, or if you got here as fast as you can, you've seen Will Rogers and Subsuds. You've seen Will Rogers, and you've seen Pioneer Towers, and now you have the opportunity to celebrate the new Dickies Arena. Ed, thank you for that. It's beautiful. The tower's new LED lights will help us celebrate so many milestones in our community. Maybe a Horned Frog victory this weekend, right? Go Frogs. Or how about red, white, and blue for the next running of the Stock Show and Rodeo? When it was built in 1936, it was a great example of public-private partnerships. Today, those public-private partnerships are still alive and well, and they're what make Fort Worth so incredibly special and so incredibly strong. And I mentioned the Dickies Arena. That's probably the premier public-private partnership that anyone has ever seen. I want to thank my council members who are here tonight, Carlos Flores, Ann Zeta, Dennis Shingleton, who you'll meet in a minute. But I also want to thank City Manager David Cook and Assistant City Manager Jay Choppa. They've worked really hard to make this a reality. Thank you for your hard work on this. And I don't know where they are, but as well as our friends at McElroy Falls, who've been involved in so many projects, and I gotta say, this one was a challenge, right? But they did it. There's a little bit of work still to be done that'll be finished long before the rodeo, and it's going to be beautiful tonight. Tonight's unveiling, an 83-year-old tower will shine like a beacon for citizens of Fort Worth to come to the home of cowboys and culture, and you are smack dab in the middle of it tonight. So thank you all for being here to help us celebrate. It's my pleasure now to turn it over to Mayor Pro Tem, Councilmember Dennis Shingleton. Dennis?
Good evening. What a great evening. Somebody said it was going to rain tonight. What the hell do they know? You know, my job here today is to kind of identify and recognize some people that have had been instrumental, not only in this, but there's a couple of this project, but this wonderful Will Rogers campus. You know, this 208-foot tower. Wow, what a, we're going to bring this back to life tonight. But the original architect, his name is Hendricks, Wyatt Hendricks. And, you know, I don't know, I don't think that he had Ed Bass's oversight when he was designing this. I think Ed was probably pretty young then, but he's done a wonderful job, Ed, and you've done a wonderful job tailoring your enterprises on this campus to his enterprise here. And I think that deserves a round of applause with the arena and all of this. Thank you. Becky recognized McElroy and Falls, who did the contractor. They did a superb job here. But the architect, or Elements of Architecture, and they've done, and that's the name of the company, they've done a superb job also. So thank you very much to the Elements of Architecture. I got a shout out here this evening. You know, this whole relighting is about history and cowboys and culture and maintaining that equestrian culture that we have in this city, is how important it is. But I've got a few young ladies here this evening. Brownie Troop 2529. They're here for a historic merit badge this evening, so thank you to them for coming. You know, there's some city groups here, there's some city staff here that also need some recognition, and that's Steve Cook and the property management group. Thank you, Steve. Brandon Bennett and Code Compliance were actively involved in this. And then the public art group, Karen Wiley. I know she's here. I saw her. She bumped into me here just a few minutes ago. Karen, thank you very much. And certainly the last one is Richard Zavala, who Parks Department and enterprises at the convention center that he runs and this entire campus. Richard's done a great job as the interim guy in charge of this. So that being said, I think we're ready to flip the switch on this baby. Let's do it. This was not the low bidder. Thank you. As usual, I forgot one person. Kevin Kemp, the general manager of the Will Rogers Complex, is here somewhere. Kevin, thank you very much. This will be on every evening. Every evening we'll have this lit. So bring your kids, your grandkids, moms, dads, everyone. Thank you all very much for coming. We are adjourned. Yeah.